Right, before she takes a movie break to film in France.
How nice.
Michaela Watkins on the way here. And we're glad you're, okay, so you saw this Will Poulter, Amy Farrell, Michaela Watson movie.
Yeah.
Watkins, and you laughed your head off.
I did, yeah. Or Will Ferrell, Amy Poehler, yeah. There we go. It's, oh my gosh, it is so funny. These two are just, they can do anything. I mean, they could sit there and read the shampoo bottle and we'd all be like, ha, <course." laughs> But yeah, no, this movie, The House, is, they're in their zone, they're in their element, they kill it. And so Jason Mantzoukas also stars in it. And he, I don't know if you're familiar with him, but you will be after this because he also is, he's the third leg of the tripod.
Right.
And that worked.
Yeah. But having had considerable success in a bunch of different comedies, we'll talk about Casual in a second. Mm-hmm. Do you laugh often? Do you know what I mean? Do you laugh often, or because you know it, and then?
No, I have a strict no laughing rule when I'm
right.
I am a professional.
Right.
I'm not interested in hijinks. Actually, what was happening when the camera was not on
right.
was infinitely funnier because very unedited and
right.
very spontaneous. These are improvisers, so.
Yeah.
A lot of the movie, there's a script, but a lot of it was just like what everybody felt like saying.
How about that Andrew J. Cohen, though, the director?
Oh, isn't he great?
A guest on the Frank Buckley podcast.
Today. Mm-hmm.
Really?
Which drops today.
He's so great. Yeah, that no, he wrote a great script, and he co-wrote a great script, and he directed a great movie. Yeah.
Speaking of writing, we're going to look at a clip of Casual in a second for an episode that you wrote.
What? I co-wrote it right. with Tommy Dewey, who plays my bro
right.
on the show. And yeah, it was also really fun because I've created things that you write where you're like, maybe this character's like this, but we knew these characters through and through, and we got to really get messy, roll our sleeves up.
There.
Yeah.
Get our hands in the dirt.
Yes.
I'm all about metaphors.
Okay, right. It's a whole ceramic experience. Here, Casual, and she can mouth the lines because she wrote them. Watch.
Jeez, look at this incredible awkwardness here. Plan going as intended. I'll get her some very early morning Cabernet Sauvignons and impress her with the fact that I know the word Matisse.
Mm-hmm.
Fake phone call alert.
Please, somebody call me. Somebody be dead. And just like that, we've run out of everything to say.
Try one of these.
Hmm?
Oh. Good, huh?
It was very good. So, I don't mean to sound overly clinical here, but how's this gonna work?
Oh,
you know what? Okay, what was really good about that?
That's a loaded question.
But how very real that play.
Thank you. And what's interestingly, we shot at right here in Los Angeles at LACMA, the LA County Museum of Wonderful Art, and which is, you know, an incredible location because it's a very sexy location. And there I was, obviously on a loaded date. Interestingly, that couple that was walking by, that was improv, because we were trying to say, like, if you know how you do that on a date where you're like, what would they be saying to each other? And it's sort of a way to deflect kind of the tension off of yourselves. And then when he feeds her the charcuterie plate, then she's got to deal with what's in front of her. But
he loves charcuterie.
Interestingly,
this is very true. If you see on my Twitter, when I wrote with Tommy, if he would get a little antsy or like, let's get to the next scene, I would feed him and I made him a huge charcuterie board, and that's how it ended up.
Oh, that is fantastic.
For those who can't even spell charcuterie, are you more cheese, meats, or the weird like gherkins and stuff like that?
I'm all of it. To be honest, it's not like I, you know, always have a ready to go charcuterie board in my kitchen. We had a party the night before and they were leftovers.
All right.
But he doesn't need to know that. Yeah. He can think that I'm really fancy.
But what's your balance of those things?
It's got to be very balanced. You have to have meat and cheese and gherkins.
And good bread.
And good bread. Or a hearty cracker.
Crackers, good crackers.
A hearty cracker.
A little quince paste.
A quince paste.
Come on.
Come on.
Quince paste.
Too fancy now.
Now you always keep being elite.
Yeah.
Quince almonds.
Paste. Oh.
Yeah.
Blanched almonds.
Maybe something editorial, like a plant from your garden.
All right, so when you jet off to France, mm-hmm. are you doing this movie because I'm sure it's a good movie, or are you doing it because you can't imagine the craft services they're going to have a movie in France?
Oh, yeah. I have heard, and I don't know if this is true, but I have heard that their actors union in France I'm going to shoot a film there. It's called Under the Eiffel Tower with Matt Walsh, who you probably have.
Oh, sure, from Veep.
From Veep. It's a lot of people from Veep are going to be on that, actually. I have heard, and I don't know if this is confirmed, that they serve wine at lunch.
Yes,
in
I bet they do.
Yes. Is this, you guys know this?
We don't.
No, we well, don't, Jess, we assume.
Jessica's actually been in a series of obscure French movies. None of which have ever been released.
We've actually, there's a temporary restraining order.
Such a shame.
Yeah. And the lunch is 2 hours long, and then nothing gets done after lunch because everybody's
over. You had a bottle.
Yeah, they had a bottle, yeah.
Book me. Michaela is on Casual, which of course, as you know, is on Hulu. The House is in theaters everywhere tomorrow. Come back after France and we can compare their lunches to charcuterie.
Yeah, okay.
But don't come without a jar of quince paste.
Why would I ever do that? What kind of a maniac would do that?
Thank you, Michaela. Thank you.
Still ahead, a sailor gets the surprise of a lifetime.
The Southern California man arrives home to see a big secret being kept by his wife.
Plus, she's a singer with shows coming up at the Troubadour and House of Blues. Bea Miller joins us live with more on that and her upcoming album release.
And who needs a water boy on the sidelines when you have a water dog? Meet Jake when we come back.